Robots in the US cost the same as robots in China, and so we can be competitive if we automate enough of our manufacturing processes.
Welcome to ContECHtual, where we show you the history and the future of all the tech you're using and coveting.
After years of just being an industrial tool, 3D printers finally made their way to the consumer market in the 2000s, and now they're making their way into the homes of regular people who couldn't afford to buy a $10,000 machine for printing cool forks,
knives,
spoons. Plastic
sure.
things.
So today, we're going to try it out.
Now, no one wants to see just one 3D printer. I mean, am I right?
That's
boring. So 2000s.
Yeah.
So we're going to Voodoo Manufacturing to see, like, way too many 3D printers.
Like, maybe four or five.
More than that.
Oh my God, well, let's go.
Manufacturing in the US is growing again as automation takes hold because robots in the US cost the same as robots in China, and so we can be competitive if we automate enough of our manufacturing processes. Digital manufacturing is any process where you can feed a digital file into a machine and out comes like a physical product. So with organs or with food or with anything like that, the value really comes from that digital to physical pipeline, which allows you to iterate quickly, try things or customize them. That's really what 3D printing is all about.
It's so cool that like we're just in this room that's like no bigger than like, I don't know, I guess a classroom, and there's just machines going nuts.
So that's kind of the funny part about the factory. I don't actually know what's going on most of the time on every individual printer. So that's why we have these screens here.
Yeah.
So this tablet is a view into what is happening on this cluster of printers.
Ninja Star. They're so ornate. The things that are being designed are so intricate.
If someone just goes online, clicks a button, clicks purchase, it's just sent right to your machines, which are then made. You know, they make the product and then they ship it off.
It's so cool. And it's so cool to see things like in their infant stages and then going over to the next printer and seeing it almost done. Like,
the average is maybe around 10 hours. Yeah. Kind of slow. Some people think like, wow, 10 hours to make something? That kind of takes a while. But everything else in our pipeline is so fast. The digital file comes into our software, it starts printing immediately, and you can place an order at 6 p.m. and it can be done the next morning. That's actually really fast.
The density of this space can actually double or increase like even more than that. Like we can stack these not just two high, but maybe three high or four high.
Eventually the goal is to kind of rope that area off and have robots doing all of the machine tending so they can run 24/7 lights out without people actually running them.
Thanks so much for joining us. Next week, we get our faces scanned.
Not again.